I don't know about you, but I know for me, quarantine wreaked havoc on my eating habits, and I ate just about everything I could, which is why we're calling our friends over at Intermountain Healthcare. I am a big fan of dietitians, and they've changed my life. I want to bring in Julie Opp, who's a registered dietitian. How are you, Miss Julie?
I'm doing great this morning. It's a beautiful sunny morning. I'm doing fine.
It is beautiful. Now let's talk, because I think everybody, you know, we were reaching for things that we may not typically have reached for. We were eating more than normal. So now we're trying to make these changes and get back to a better healthy lifestyle. Where can we start?
So we want to start with small changes. So many times we try to change everything at once or make a big change and we set ourselves up for failure. But making small changes like, well, let's cut back on added sugar, or let's try drinking water instead of sugary sodas, or slowing down when we eat, or trying something new. So one small change at a time breeds confidence, it breeds success, and it helps you move on to the next change.
100%. Firm believer in that, and it will definitely help you in the long run. Now, you've got some fun ideas, like maybe making jicama as french fries instead of the actual french fries?
Yeah. So everybody that knows me knows that jicama is one of my favorite vegetables. It's kind of known as the Mexican potato or South American potato. But it's not starchy like a potato. It's very crisp and juicy, very high in fiber. And I just looked up a recipe last night for jicama fries. So it's a great alternative to french fries. And the people that have tried it online, you know, reading those blog recipes, they just love it. And I really enjoyed that. And you're not eating all that starch. So it's great.
What a brilliant idea. And I don't know why I didn't think of that, but maybe adding it to your stir fry or anything like that. I used to be a big fan of jicama and I forgot about it. So I'm glad you reminded me all this.
My favorite way to eat is cut it up in sticks and just eat it as a snack. I don't need anything with it. It's a good crunch. It has a great crunchy texture.
And having those good snacks, I think that's one of the biggest things for me. If I have good snacks that I've maybe prepped and have in the fridge, that's when I don't get myself into trouble.
If you don't have them prepped, we get in trouble, right?
Yes. Yep. If I don't have them prepped, then if they are prepped, then I do much better.
Yeah, absolutely. I would totally agree. And I think all my clients would agree with you as well.
Now, if people are wanting to meet with a dietitian, how can they do so? And if they're nervous about it or, you know, anything like that, what would you say?
They just call our number or find us online and just say, hey, I'm interested in an appointment. We see a tremendous variety of patients, different health needs, maybe medical needs, but we also see a lot of people that just want to eat healthier and get healthier. So really they just need to call us and make that appointment. That's all it takes.
I love it. Well, and you're full of a lot of great ideas. So Julie, thank you so much. We appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
You're welcome. See you later.
Okay. Bye-bye.